friends. Julie here. I wanted to take a second to talk about something important to me. This radio station. I try not to talk about myself too much, but maybe you've heard me mention it before. I'm only 23, but I've had more than my share of bad times. I don't say that to get you to feel sorry for me. I know that so many of you out there have had difficult lives, too. Some far, far harder than mine. I say it because I want you to know I can relate. I know what it's like to lose family and friends, to struggle. There's one thing that always kept me going, always meant something to me. It's this place, this radio station, this music. These songs playing out across the world for everyone to hear, they mean so much to me. They remind me of good times, of people I care about, things that really matter. They offer hope. I know it's cheesy, but hey, it's true. When I heard that people were coming back to Appalachia, I knew I had to make the trip to find this radio station and make sure it stays running. I'm not gonna act like it's mine, like I own it or anything. I've fixed some things up, sure, but I didn't build Appalachia Radio. It doesn't belong to me. But I want to make sure it stays on the air because maybe it can give someone else hope. Maybe that someone is you. So I hope you hear this music and it makes you smile or makes you think of someone you care about. That's what it's here for. That's what I'm here for. I guess I should probably get back to actually playing all that music I keep talking about, huh? Wondering what's up with Old Man Moe's? Here's Eddie Duchin to fill you in.
Once there was a little old man with a funny crooked nose. He lived down in the log hut and we called him Old Man Moe. One dark and dreary morning I knocked upon his door. Well, I didn't hear a single sound and I ain't gonna do it no more. Cause I believe,
Old Man,
yes I believe,
Old Man,
I do believe,
Old Man,
that Old Man Moe's is dead. Whoa, I believe,
Old Man,
I sure believe,
Old Man,
yes I believe,
Old Man,
that Old Man Moe's is dead.
We believe.
He kicked the bucket,
we
yeah
believe.
Man, buck, buck, bucket,
we believe.
He kicked the bucket and Old Man Moe's is dead,
we believe.
Oh, bucket,
we believe.
Buck, buck, bucket,
we believe.
He kicked the bucket and Old Man Moe's is dead. I went round to a window and I peeked into a crack. Inside the walls that little old man lying flat upon his back. And I knew he wasn't sleeping cause his hands hung to the floor. Well, I didn't hear a single sound and I ain't gonna do it no more. Cause I found out,
Old Man,
yes, I found out,
Old Man,
I sure found out,
Old Man,
that Old Man Moe's is dead. I found out,
Old Man,
oh, I found out,
Old Man,
yeah, I found out,
Old Man,
that Old Man Moe's is dead.
We found out.
He kicked the bucket,
we
yeah,
found
man,
out.
Buck, buck, bucket,
we found out.
He kicked the bucket and Old Man Moe's is dead.
We found out.
Oh, bucket.
We found out.
Buck, buck,
bucket. We found out.
He kicked the bucket and Old Man Moe's is dead.
Welcome. Welcome back, dear listeners. It's time once again to put aside all you think you know, all you believe to be true. Time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. Tonight's episode, Who Goes There? The Strange Encounter in Flatwoods, is brought to you by Sugar Bombs, the breakfast cereal with explosive great taste and 100% of the recommended daily allowance of sugar. Get your morning started right with Sugar Bombs. Our tale begins on a fateful night when a young pioneer scout, Fred Fisher, finds himself in quite the predicament, having taken a spill and fallen into a dark place.
Where am I? Jack? Biff? Mr. Bailey? Can anybody hear me?
I can hear you.
Who's there? I can't see you.
Me? My name's Sally. What's yours?
Fred.
Are you okay, Fred?
I think so. My head's a little woozy. Must have hit it when I fell.
Oh, no. Did you get lost, too?
Well, sort of. What I mean is that I was camping with my scout troop by the lake near Flatwoods. There were these lights kind of dancing in the sky.
Neat.
I guess. Anyway, we heard some weird noises, and the guy's double dog dared me to go look, so I did.
All by yourself? You're really brave.
Shucks. Thanks. I followed the noises to an entrance of an old mine. It smelled awful there, like rotten eggs, but worse. Suddenly, there was this bright light shining down on me. I was super scared and ran to the mine to hide, but everything felt strange. Like, my feet weren't even touching the ground. Everything went black, and I woke up here in the dark.
That all happened to me, too. We'll just do what my dad says. When you've strayed or lost your foot, do what's best and stay put. They said they'd bring him soon.
There are other people here?
Yeah, they probably just went to get more food. They'll be back soon enough. You can wait with me, and they'll give you food too. You just have to do what they want.
What do you mean?
When they want to play games with you.
Games? What kind of games?
I'm still learning the rules. Mostly, they're kind of boring and only hurt when they use the needles.
Needles?
Yeah, you know, like at the doctor.
This doesn't sound like any game I know. It sounds downright awful, and these people sound really bad. We have to get out of here.
No, no, stay put, stay put, stay put, stay put!
Okay, okay, stop screaming! Ah, the light, it's so bright.
That's where they come in to bring food, or when it's time to play.
Sally, what's that helmet thing you're wearing? It looks like it's screwed into your head.
Time to play. Time to play.
Sally!
Time.
What's wrong?
To
Why are you laughing play. Like that?
Time to play.
Oh, I see them now.
Time
they,
to
They aren't human at all.
Time to
No! Stop! Let me go!
Time
Sally, help me!
Okay.
I don't want to play! I don't want to play any games! No!
Fred Fisher was found days later, wandering by the river outside Flatwoods. He was disoriented, but unharmed, save for two small wounds on each temple. To this day, Fred is convinced his strange encounter was real and even continues to search high and low for a missing girl named Sally, whom he swears he met. So I leave it to you to decide, dear listeners. Was this simply the wild imagination of a frightened boy lost in the woods? Or was Fred Fisher, in fact, abducted by brainwashing aliens from outer space? Be sure to tune in next week for another thrilling chapter of Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
It's a little passive-aggressive, but it seems to work for him. Here's Milton Brown with Keep Knocking, But You Can't Come In.
Keep knocking, but you can't come in. Keep knocking, but you can't come in. Keep knocking, but you can't come in. Guess you better let me be. Kinda busy, so you can't come in. Kinda busy, so you can't come in. I'm kinda busy, so you can't come in. Guess you better let me be. Chance, so you can't come in. You had your chance, so you can't come in. You had your chance, so you can't come in. Guess you better let me be. Shake my doorknob, but you can't come in. Shake my doorknob, but you can't come in. Shake my doorknob, but you can't come in. Guess you better let me be. Me on the rack, and I'd be there when you got back, but I'm running on another track. Guess you better let me be. I know you've been drinking gin, running around with other men. Keep knocking, but you can't get in. Guess you'd better let me be. But you can't come in. Keep booting, but you can't come in. Busy booting, but you can't come in. Guess you better let me be. Kinda busy, but you can't come in. Keep knocking and you can't come in. Keep knocking and you can't come in. Guess you better let me be.
Got a doll, baby, I love her so. Nothing else like her anywhere you go. A man, she's anything but calm. Regular pint-size atom bomb.
Atom bomb, baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT. Pleada, pleada, pleada.
Atom bomb baby, loaded with power, radioactive as a TV tower. A nuclear fission in her soul, loves with the electronic control.
Atom bomb baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT.
Atom bomb baby, boy she can start one of those chain reactions in my heart. A big explosion, big and loud, mushrooms me right up on a cloud.
Atom bomb baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT. Bum, pleada, bum, pleada, bum, pleada, bum.
Atom bomb baby, sweet as a plum, carries more wild than uranium. When she kisses, there's no hitch. 0 hour, she turns on the switch.
Atom bomb baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT. Atom bomb baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT.
I meant it as a compliment. But, I don't know, something about comparing your girl to an explosive device that can destroy the world? You see what I'm saying, right?
Oh, give me land, lots of land, under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze and listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, don't fence me in.
Just turn me loose, let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western sky. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise.
I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences and gaze at the moon till I lose my senses. And I can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in.
Oh, give me land, lots of land under starry skies. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide country that I love. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze and listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, don't fence me in.
Just turn me loose, let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies.
On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise.
Ba 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 ba.
I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences and gaze at the moon till I lose my senses. And I can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in. No,
Papa, don't you fence me in.
Well, Mr. Bing Crosby, you would have loved Appalachia. More wide open land than you can shake a mildly irradiated stick at.
They say that there's a guy they call Bigfoot Pete. He plays piano by ear, and he'll play all night for pigs, feet, and beer. He's murder on the 88. He's the guy who brought the boogie-woogie up to date. He's got a cannon in his left hand and a rifle in his right. He's just a double-barreled kid, and he shoots the 8 feet to you at a frightening rate. He's just a solid whiz, I'll tell you who he is. He's Bigfoot Pete, a boogie-woogie's elite. His hands are just as big as Virginia hams, and when they go to work, they're like battering rams. And when he plays on that box, the joint rocks until you beat to your socks. Wherever boogie is part of the plan, you find a Bigfoot Pete, the boogie-woogie man. Thank you. you is. He's Bigfoot Pete, a boogie woogie's a lead. His hands are just as big as Virginia hams. And when they go to work, they're like battering rams. And when he plays all that box, the joint rocks until you beat to your socks. Wherever boogie is part of the plan, you find a Bigfoot Pete, the boogie woogie man. They call him Bigfoot, the boogie woogie man.
A nickname for someone I really like and or admire, I'm probably not gonna go with Pigfoot or anything of the sort. What do you think, friends?
And stage satellites, social devs, and high havelites, masters, glasses, doing the uptown lowdown, where they spend their simoleons just to watch those Creoleans skipping, hipping, doing the uptown lowdown. You'll find laughter after midnight, that's their playtime, highly hay time. What price? Yeah, man. Bankers with their Cinderellas listening to those high-elatives up in Harlem doing the uptown lowdown.
Chains and a line of jive. He's a mellow old cat.
he's coming on, all going, Mr. Five by Five. He's slightly plump on his butter side. He don't shake it no more from head to toe, and he do from side to side.
Jump it for a fat man.
Fat man!
Boys, the trouble is there's no way of knowing
whether he's coming on or going, Mr. Five by Five. He's 5 feet tall and he's 5 feet wide. He don't measure no more from head to toe than it do from side to side.
That was, if you hadn't picked up on it, Mr. 5x5. I always feel just a little bit bad for the poor guy that song was about. But it sounds like he was a pretty good dancer, so good for him.
Welcome back, dear listeners. It's time once again to put aside all you think you know, all you believe to be true. Time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. It has been said that money is the root of all evil. So, when greed knows no bounds and avarice goes unchecked, what other appetites might take hold? Tonight's gripping tale, Curse of the Windigo, chews over this very question. We begin at the Corvega Auto Assembly Plant in Huntersville, West Virginia, where plant owner and operator Richard Moore is known for squeezing every ounce of profitability from his workforce.
Excellent. Excellent.
Dick, mind if I have a word?
Sure, Bill, come right in. These productivity reports exceeded my projections. Get ready for another juicy holiday bonus.
Sounds swell, boss. But I was walking the floor, and I noticed that the plutonium containment levels are all looking a bit high.
I ordered that line to be sped up last night by 20%. I think the tolerances can handle it.
Well, I understand wanting to be more efficient, but if those plutonium cells don't cool properly...
Come now. With great risk comes great reward, see?
Still, that's a lot of risk you're taking with the safety of the crew.
They'll be thanking me come bonus time. After all, money puts food on the table.
Warning, containment meltdown. Warning, containment meltdown.
More containment is rupturing.
We need to get clear. Come on, let's go.
What about the men on the line?
Nothing we can do for those poor saps now. Just hope you and I can make it.
Darling, we're home. Are you up?
Welcome back, Mum. Happy to report your husband is on the mend. His radiation levels are decreasing just as the doctor predicted.
Splendid. Thank you, Godrich.
Godrich, look at my new cap gun. Isn't it swell?
A marvel to behold, Master Jim. By the by, Mum, I do say, Mr. Richard certainly seems to have his appetite back. He's eaten twice again since lunch, yet still appears hungry. A very good sign of recovery indeed.
Yes, I suppose that is good news.
That you, dear? Say, did you buy more steaks?
As I was saying, Mum, he's eaten up every last steak, meatball, and banger, I'm afraid.
Oh, my. Sorry, darling. I'll go to the butcher tomorrow. Insistent, isn't he?
Yes, Mum. Quite.
Can I show Dad my gun?
Jimmy, I told you, not in the house. And remember, you can't go into the bedroom yet.
Aw, stupid quarantine.
I know it's hard, sweetheart, but we just have to be patient. This happens to lots of people with important jobs like your father's.
Okay, I won't go in. I'll just say hi. Dad? Dad, did you fall asleep?
Jimmy, that you out there, sport?
Yeah, it's me.
Jimmy, I'm hungry.
Okay, Dad. I'll go tell Godrich to make you something.
No. Why don't you come in, son? Pay your old man a visit.
I'm not supposed to get too close yet, remember?
Now, James, if your father says it's okay, then it's okay. Now, you come in here.
I don't know. You sure?
Positive. You come and give your dad a big hug. Now, Jimmy.
Well, all right. If you say it's okay.
There he is. There's my boy, looking fit as a fiddle.
Dad, what's wrong? You don't look better at all. You've gotten so thin I can see your bones. And you've lost all your hair, too. You look almost like a skeleton.
Oh, so sorry, Jimmy. But Daddy's hungry. So very, very hungry. Come closer, son. Come to Daddy.
What? No, Dad, no!
Was it the radiation, a side effect of the medication? Or was it greed that caused this carnivorous transformation? We may never know. Be sure to tune in next week for another thrilling chapter of Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
I hear you calling, hi-oh, you rolling river. Oh, Shenandoah, I long to hear you, hi-oh, I'm bound away. The wide Missouri, Missouri, she's a mighty river. Topsail shiver, hi-oh, I'm bound away, across the wide Missouri. Farewell, my dearest, I'm bound to leave you, hi-oh, you rolling river. Shenandoah, I'll not deceive you. Hi-o, I'm bound away across the wide Missouri.
I don't know about you all, but being a kid, sipping a Nuka-Cola, and dancing around the camp listening to this song, there's no feeling like it. Makes me happy every time I hear it. Here's Jukebox Saturday Night.
Mopping up soda pop rickies to our heart's delight.
Dancing to the swingaroo quickies, Jukebox Saturday Night.
Goodman and Kaiser and Miller help to make things bright.
Mixing hot licks with vanilla, Jukebox Saturday Night. They put nothing past us,
me and Honey Lamb,
making one coke last us
till it's time to scram.
Money we really don't need that,
we make out all right.
Let the other guy feed that Jukebox Saturday Night.
After sipping a soda, we got a scheme. Somebody else plays the record machine. It's so easy to say pet names when you listen to the trumpet of Harry James.
Shack and it's built way back about 25 feet from the railroad track. Lingers on
Haile Selassie. If I were king, wouldn't mean a thing. Put my boots on tall, read the writing on the wall, and it wouldn't mean a thing, not a doggone thing. There's a queen waiting there in a rocking chair, just blowing her top on Gator's beer. Looking all around and trucking on down, 'cause I'm glad to get back to my shanty town.
Of time. It's educational.
We three, we're all alone, living in a memory. My echo, my shadow, and me. We three, we're not a crowd, we're not even company. My echo, my shadow, and me. What good is the moonlight, the silvery moonlight that shines above? I walk with my shadow, I talk with my echo, but where is the one I love? We three will wait for you, even till eternity. My echo, my shadow, and me.
We three, we're all alone. Seem like we're living in a memory. That's my echo, my shadow, and me. We three, we ain't no crowd. Fact is, we ain't even company. That's my echo, my shadow, and me. You know, I've been wondering, what good is the moonlight, that silvery moonlight that shines way, way up above? Yeah, I walk with my shadow, I talk with my echo, but where is that gal that I love?
We three will wait for you, even till eternity. My my shadow and me.
Remember, friends, you're not alone out there. The world is filled with people, and you share the same goals with at least some of them. Take care of yourselves and each other, okay? The Andrews sisters and Bing Crosby are back again, this time with Pistol Packin' Mama.
Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol Packin' Mama, lay that pistol down. Oh, drinking beer in a cabaret, was I having fun? Until one night she caught me right, now I'm on the run.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol Packin' Mama, lay that pistol down. Oh, I see you every night, Bing, and I'll woo you every day. I'll be your regular mama, and I'll put that gun away.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol Packin' Mama, lay the thing down before it goes off and hurts somebody. Oh, she kicked up my windshield, and she hit me over the head. She cussed and cried and said I'd lied, and she wished that I was dead.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol Packin' Mama, lay that pistol down. We're three tough gals from deep down Texas way. We got no pals, they don't like the way we play. We're a rough, rootin', tootin', shootin' trio, but you ought to see my sister Cleo. She's a terror, make no error, but there ain't no laissez-faire. Here's what we tell her.
Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol Packin' Mama, lay that pistol down.
Corn, the revenuers came. The draw was slow, so now they know you can't do that to Maine.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down.
Pistol Packin' Mama, lay that pistol down.
Oh, singing songs in a cabaret, was I having fun? Till one night it didn't seem right, now I'm on the run.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol Packin' Mama, lay that pistol
down.
Oh, Pistol Packin' Mama, lay that pistol
me. But when I got here, the equipment was days away from breaking down. You were all saved from hearing this song, and only this song, repeating. Endlessly, forever.
But rewound the clock, since the Puritans got the shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock, Plymouth Rock would land on them. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Good offers too, who once knew better words, now only use four letter words, writing prose. Anything goes. If driving fast calls you like, if low balls you like, if old hymns you like, if fair limbs you like, if Mae West you like, or me undressed you like, why nobody will oppose. When every night the set that's smart is intruding and nudist parties in studio, anything goes. When the Mrs. Ned McLean, God bless her, can get Russian red to yes, then I suppose anything goes. When Rockefeller still can hoard enough money to let Max Gordon produce his show, anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today, and that gent today, you gave a cent today, once had several chateaus. When folks who still can ride in jitneys find out Vanderbilts and Whitneys lack baby clothes, anything goes. When Sam Goldwyn can with great conviction instruct Anna Sten in diction, then Anna shows anything goes. When you hear that Lady Mendel standing up, now does a handspring landing up on her toes, anything goes. Just think of those shots you got, and those knocks you got, and those blues you got from those news you got, and those pains you got in any things you got from those little radios. So Mrs. R, with all her trimmings, can broadcast a bed from Simmons, cause Frank will know anything goes.
Okay, everyone, here it comes. Grab your pals, maybe a banjo, and belt it out along with the radio. I know you've been waiting for this one.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is all there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like the breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. All my memories gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water, dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste the moonshine, teardrops in my eye. Country roads, take me home.
Take me home, take me home, take me home, take me home. meat.
He's hacking and whacking and smacking. He's hacking and whacking and smacking. He's hacking and whacking and smacking. He just hacks, whacks, chopping that meat.
But your Pete's got a long, sharp knife. He starts chopping and don't know when to stop. All you fellas better watch your wives, cause Pete don't care whose meat he chops.
He's hacking and whacking and smacking.
Over. You ain't heard nothing yet.
I wish I knew the story behind this next song, because it was written so long ago, but it's so appropriate pretty much every day in Appalachia. Here is Praise the Lord and Pass the Ammunition.
Free!
sleep a wink, that is true. I'm hoping and I'm praying as my heart breaks right in two. Walking the floor over you. You left me and you went away. You said that you'd be back in just a day. You've broken your promise and you left me here alone. I don't know why you did, dear, but I do know that you're gone. I'm walking the floor over you. I can't sleep a wink, that is true. I'm hoping and I'm praying as my heart breaks right in two. Walking the floor over you. Off any bird now. Someday you may be lonesome too. Walking the floor is good for you. Just keep right on walking and it won't hurt you to cry. Remember that I love you and I will the day I die. I'm walking the floor over you. I can't sleep a wink, that is true. And I'm praying as my heart breaks right in two. Walk in the pool.
Lost love. Is there a more significant source of inspiration for music? I think not, my friends. Let's hope you all fare better than Mr. Tubb.
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him two lips like roses and clover. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. Sandman, don't have nobody to call my own.
Bum, 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 bum.
Please turn on your magic beam. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him the word that I'm not a rover. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. Sandman, I'm so alone. Don't have nobody to call my own. Please turn on your magic beam. Oh, Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream.
Bum, 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 bum.
Sandman.
Yes?
Bring us a dream. Give him a pair of eyes with a come hither gleam. Give him a lonely heart like Pagliacci. And lots of wavy hair like Liberace. Mr. Sandman, someone to hold.
Someone to hold.
Would be so peachy before we're too old. So please turn on your magic beam. Sandman, bring us, please, 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 Mr. Sandman, bring us a dream.
Isn't that one a classic? I feel like everyone knows the first few lines, and then after that, they're often just mumbling along, not knowing the rest of the words. Always fun to see. Stim packs won't heal these burns. Here comes the Ring of Fire.
Mm-hmm.
fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. It went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. It went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours beat. I fell for you just like a child. But the fire is wild. I fell into a burning in a fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. Birds, birds, birds.
Welcome back, dear listeners. It's time once again to put aside all you think you know, all you believe to be true. Time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. Not all creatures are of the land. Some stalk the skies. One such boogeyman has been reported for generations by mystified West Virginians. Its name remains the same, but accounts and speculation about its nature vary wildly. Some say man, others say beast, some say devil, others say angel. Tonight's tale, The Mothman Cometh, begins in Morgantown Municipal Hospital. We join young Mary Scarberry's bedside as she wakes, looking a little worse for wear.
Nurse? Nurse Handy? Are you there?
Right here, ma chérie. And how are you feeling? Perhaps another stim pack will help.
Is she awake?
There she is.
I heard her voice.
How's my brave little girl?
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. I'm doing okay. Oh, we've been worried sick. Oh, you gave us such a fright.
Howdy, folks. Awful sorry to disturb you at this hour.
Mary, this is Sheriff Johnson. He just wanted to ask a few questions.
Well, from what I hear, you're downright lucky to be alive, Miss Mary. You kids went through quite an ordeal.
Steve and Buddy, are they okay?
Let's just have a little chat first, Mary. Now, do you remember how you came to be on the Fayetteville Railroad Bridge yesterday?
Well, going to the bridge was really Buddy's idea.
Come on, Mary. Don't wimp out. Every kid's got to do it sometime.
But Buddy, you know I'm plumb scared of heights. How far you reckon that drop is, Steve?
My daddy says 1,000 feet. I heard it's 2,000 feet. Plenty of time to say last words and final prayers before you hit the river.
Stop teasing me. I told y'all I'm nervous enough already.
Come on. Quit your stalling. Here, watch me. There's nothing to it.
Buddy, be careful.
Last one across is round egg.
Here goes.
Atta girl. Come on.
Slow down. I gotta take my time.
You're doing swell, Mary.
Oh, no. I don't think I can go any further.
You can't chicken out now. Just put one foot in front of the other.
Hey, y'all. Look. Up in the sky.
Dang. What is that? It's too big to be a bird. Wait. I know what it is. See how its eyes are glowing red? It's the Mothman.
Says that the Mothman's a sign of bad things. Bet that means the train's gonna derail.
Or maybe the bad thing is the train squashing us like June bugs. What are we gonna do?
We can't jump. And it's too late to run. The train's almost here.
Look out! That thing's coming back.
Remember, is the Mothman snatching me and Steve just before the train ran us over. Sheriff, I know it sounds crazy, but I reckon it saved my life.
Well, now that's quite a tale, Mary.
You do believe me, don't you? I swear that's how it all happened. Just ask Buddy and Steve. They'll tell you the same story. Go on, ask them.
Mr. and Mrs. Scarberry, could I speak to you outside a moment?
Of course. Sweetheart, we'll be right back. You just get some rest.
Nurse, could you please get her something to eat?
Right away, madam. One Salisbury steak with extra gravy coming up. We'll have your highest rain in no time, my cherie.
What do you think, Sheriff? Mary's not one to fib, but that story.
All I know is that she was found unconscious by the river without so much as a scratch.
So then you think she was telling the truth about this Mothman saving her and those boys?
Well, that's the thing about it, ma'am. Those other boys weren't as lucky as Mary. The grim truth is that both were found dismembered way up in the top of a tree.
On top of a... Oh, you don't think.
What's that sound? It sounds like a... Mary!
The window. It smashed right in.
The nurse is torn to pieces, too!
Why does what?
Mary! She's gone. What's happened to my sweet Mary? Do something, Sharon. Do something.
Yet another chilling reminder, dear listeners, to always watch your back, your left, and your right. Be careful of your step and the ground beneath your feet. But most of all, don't forget to watch the skies above. For you never know what frightful terrors might be lurking overhead. Be sure to tune in next week for another thrilling chapter of Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
buzzard took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzard tried to throw the monkey off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of diving? Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top." The buzzard told the monkey, "You are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free." The monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye and said, "Your story's so touching, it sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Bree-dee-bree-doo. Choking me, release your hold, then I will set you free. The monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye and said, "Your story's so touching, it sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top."
All right. Can you imagine three sisters all able to get along well enough to sing together? I wouldn't make it through a single song with my brother. No way. Here comes "Heading Down the Wrong Highway" by Johnny Bond. And Johnny, as long as that highway isn't overrun with super mutants or feral ghouls, it could be worse, buddy.
Too many sweethearts and none of them true. Done too many things that I shouldn't do. Made lots of money, all spent the wrong way, heading down the wrong highway. Made lots of friends and now they're all gone. Too many memories that still linger on. Had too many drinks both night and day, heading down the wrong highway. And too many tears, crowded too much in just a few years. I want to go right, but I've lost my way, heading down the wrong highway.
And all you gals better pay some mind. 'Cause if you find a man worth keeping, be satisfied, make sure to treat him kind. Because a good man is hard to find. You'll always get the other kind. Just when you think that he's your pal, you turn around and find him messing around some other gal. And then you rave, you even see him laying right in his grave. So if your man is nice, take my advice. Hug him in the morning, kiss him every night, give him plenty of loving to read him right, because that good man nowadays is hard to find. You know, girls, once I had a man of my own, yeah. And since he's gone, boy, I really miss him. You see, most girls have to kiss a man to hold him. But me, I have to hold him to kiss him. Oh, he wasn't much on looks or culture, and he had a funny pan. As a matter of fact, he wasn't much of anything, but at least he was a man. And if he comes back to my little grass shack, I'm gonna hug him in the morning, kiss him every night, give him plenty loving, treat him right, because that good man nowadays is hard to find. Yes, sorry, girls, they say that opportunity knocks but once. And when that once is gone, sister, it's gone forever. So girls, if you get a man, there's just one but. Keep a smile on your face and keep your big mouth shut. Hooray! I've learned my lesson now and everything's fine. And if he comes back, I'll never, never step out of line. Cause I know what to do when the day is through. Gonna hug him in the morning, kiss him every night, give him plenty of loving.
Looking. You know what is hard to find? Ballistic fiber. Oh my gosh.
Come listen, you fellers, so young and so fine, and seek not your fortune in the dark, dreary mines. It'll form as a habit and seep in your soul, till the stream of your blood is as black as the coal. It's dark as a dungeon and damp as the dew, where the danger is double and pleasures are few, where the rain never falls and the sun never shines. It's dark as a dungeon way down in the mines. It's many a man I have known in my day who lived just to labor his young life away, where the demons of death often come by surprise. One fall of the slate and you're buried alive. I hope when I'm gone and the ages shall roll, my body will blacken and turn into coal. Then I'll look from the door of my heavenly home and pity the miner digging my bones. It's dark as a dungeon and damp as the dew, where danger is double and pleasures are few, where the rain never falls and the sun never shines. It's dark as a dungeon way down in the mine.
Here's one that might cheer you up on a rad stormy day. Or serve as an excellent background for watching someone fall down repeatedly.
Bubbles in my beer. But come in, Tom, and give us the lowdown on it.
Tonight in a bar alone I'm sitting.
Yes?
Apart from the laughter and the cheer.
That's not good.
While scenes from the past rise before me.
Yeah.
Just watching the bubbles in my beer. A vision of someone who loved me brings a lone, silent tear to my eyes.
Oh,
I know that my life's been a failure. Just watching the bubbles in my beer.
Yeah.
Travel,
yeah,
a road saved with heartaches and tears. And I'm seeing the past that I've wasted while watching the bubbles in my beer. As I think of the heart that I've broken and of the golden chances that have passed me by.
I was afraid that's what she's coming
and
to.
And the dreams that I made now are empty.
Hot now.
As empty as the bubbles in my beer.
I know things might seem bad, but don't give up. Despite what the ink spots say, it's not all over but the crying. Heck, keep going and cry while you do it. Multitask!
It's all over but the crying. And nobody's crying but me. Friends all over know I'm trying to forget about how much I care for you. It's all over but the dreaming. Poor little dreams that keep trying to come true. It's all over but the cry, and I can't get over crying over you.
It's all over but the cry,
and nobody's crying but me.
Friends all over know I'm trying
to forget about how much I care for you.
It's all over but the dreaming. Poor little dream that keep trying to come true.
It's all over but the crying,
and I can't get over crying over you.
I know you've heard about the seven wonders of the world: the Colosseum, the Pyramids, the Mausoleum. But listen, kids, the Tower of Pisa, Grand Canyon, Niagara Falls, and the Painted Desert really enthralls. But there's an eighth to the ball wonder, who plays piano in Savannah in a manner that brings down the hearts like thunder. He's got two left hands, and they love to roam in the face. That man's got two left hands, and they make their home in the bass. He's got the right amount of fingers and the right amount of toes. He's even got two eyes right over his nose. He's got two left hands, and they love to roam in the bay. Mm-hmm. your honky-tonks. Yes, that man plays Kansas style. From Savannah up to the Bronx. Cause when he plays the boogie-woogie, or how they all applaud, he doesn't have to look to find the lost chord. He's got two left hands with a built-in beat in the bass. Got the right amount of matter in his cranium. Yes, the right amount of brains in his brainium. And when he plays, it hits you like uranium. U-235, solid jive. He's got two left hands, and he keeps them both in the groove. That man's got two left hands, and he keeps them both on the move. Oh, he can buy a new tuxedo, the kind of suit he loves. His only trouble is when he's buying gloves, cause he's got two left hands with a built-in beat in the bass. A built-in beat in the bass.
I can't be the only one who wants to see a duet with Mr. Two Left Hands here and Pigfoot Pete, right? Who's with me? Here's Steel Guitar Rag. Like Bob Wills says, kick it off, Leon.
Aboard this train, everybody get on, ready. Let's go, boys. Kick it off, Leon. Kick it off. Now.
on for another 20 minutes of solos, and it sure sounds like everyone playing would have loved doing it.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons of number 9 coal. And the straw boss said, well, to bless my soul, you load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting and trouble are my middle name. I was raised in the canebrake by an old mama lion. Can't go a high-toned woman, make me walk the line. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Quick, how many bottle caps do you think it would take to equal 16 tons? I bet one of you smarty pants dwellers can do the math on that.
Nobody's fault but mine. Nobody's fault but mine. Bottle in my soul, beloved. I have a Bible in my home. Have a Bible in my home. Bottle in my soul, beloved. Father, tell me how to read. Father, tell me how to read. I don't need my soul, beloved. Nobody fault but mine. Oh, Lord. Nobody fault but mine. I don't need my soul, beloved. Have a Bible of my own. Bible in my soul, beloved. Oh, Mother, she taught me how to read. Mother, she taught me how to read. Bible in my soul, beloved. Nobody follow but mine. No, no. Nobody's fault but mine. But I don't read my soul, beloved. And so that she taught me how to read. So that she taught me how to read.
fire in my tabula. Nobody fall but mine. Help.
Mr. Johnson lays it out pretty clear, doesn't he? Regardless of circumstances, the choices we make are what really matter. I am in no way suggesting you take this song completely literally, but, well, do what you gotta do, friends. Here's When I Get Low, I Get High.
Tonight, I said, when I get low, oh, I get high. All this hard luck in this town has found me. Nobody knows how trouble goes round and round me. Oh, I'm all alone with no one to pet me. But old rocking chair ain't never gonna get me, 'cause when I get low, oh, I get high.
Dear listeners, it's time once again to put aside all you think you know, all you believe to be true. Time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. Tonight's episode, The Beast of Grafton, is brought to you by Dandy Boy Apples. Apples so good, they never go bad. And remember, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. That's Dandy Boy Apples. Fresh, delicious, and dandy every time. Pick up a box today. Our tale begins in the rural hills near Grafton, where locals have reported a strange creature lurking in the woods. Robbie Cockrell and Peggy Mansfield were out on a date, celebrating Peggy's birthday. A full moon loomed large as they drove.
Robbie, you're going too fast.
Don't worry. This nuclear roadster handles like a dream.
Where are you taking me anyway?
I told you, it's a birthday surprise.
Way out here in the woods? There's nothing this far out of Grafton, except that hospital by the river. Wait, I bet we're going to that new drive-in over in Clarksburg, right? Just so you can show off your slick new hot rod.
Ah, come on. Don't be like that, Peggy. I just thought the drive-in would be romantic.
Oh, Robbie. Robbie, look out!
Are you okay, Peggy?
Yeah. I'm okay, I think.
What happened?
There was a huge boulder in the middle of the road. I tried to warn you, but it was too late.
But look, in the road, there's nothing there.
How could that be? I saw it plain as day in the headlights. And just look at the front end. It smashed right in. I mean, it didn't just get up and walk away. What was that?
Probably just a wolf.
It didn't sound like a wolf to me. There it is again! Whatever it is, it sounds like it's coming this way!
Look! Those lights by the river. That must be the hospital. We can get help there. Come on.
Ow! My foot! I think I hurt it in the accident. Look, I'm bleeding!
Everything's going to be okay. Here. Lean against me. There you go. See? You're doing great. Just like when we won that three-legged race in the park. We're almost to the hospital.
Oh, no. There it is. I see it. Coming out of the woods.
It's bigger than a bear.
And look, it has no head. It's just flesh and muscle and claws. Robbie, it wasn't a boulder we hit. It was that thing.
It's okay. We're here. We made it. Door's locked. Hello? Anyone in there? Help us.
Hi. What's going on? Who are you?
Police, doctor. There's been an accident. My girlfriend's injured.
There's something after us. A monster in the woods.
Oh, a monster, you say?
I know. It sounds crazy, but I hit it with my car and...
I see. It's just you two?
Yes, it's just us. Oh, won't you help us, doctor, please?
Of course we'll take care of you, my dear. Do come in. Come in.
See? I told you everything was going to be okay, Peggy. Doctor, are you going to call the police about the thing outside?
Well, all in good time, son. First, let's have a look at the girl's foot. Lie down on this table, dear.
Is it bad, doctor?
Nothing we can't fix right up. I think a little shot should do the trick.
Ow!
What's that shot for?
I told you. To fix her.
Doctor, my arm's starting to tingle. Is that normal?
Oh, yes. Quite normal.
Ow! It's really burning now.
Hold still, my dear.
Hey, why are you strapping her down like that?
Just following procedure.
In the hallway! It's the monster!
Actually, that's an entirely different subject. She's been much more agreeable than the escaped one you encountered earlier on the road.
These monsters are yours?
Why, of course, though monster is a gross mischaracterization of the extraordinary advancements in evolution we've achieved here.
My whole body's burning!
Evolution? I don't understand.
Oh, you will, my boy. You both will.
Who are those men with guns? What is this place? Hey, let go of me!
What's happening? I feel so strange.
Grumpy.
Tonight's gruesome tale taught us several things. You can't always trust a good Samaritan. Be cautious when driving through the woods near Grafton. And birthday wishes don't always come true. Be sure to tune in next week for another thrilling chapter of Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
A missionary advertised with neon sign. He tell the native population that civilization is fine. And three educated savages holler from a bamboo tree. That civilization is a thing for me to see.
So bongo, 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 I don't wanna leave the Congo. Oh, no, 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 no. Bingo, bango, bongle, I'm so happy in the jungle, I refuse to go. Don't want no bright lights, false teeth, doorbells, landlords, I make it clear.
That no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here. I look through a magazine the missionary's wife conceals.
Magazine? What happens?
I see how people who are civilized bung you with automobiles.
You know you can get hurt that way, Daniel?
At the movies they have got to pay many coconuts to see.
What do they see, Donnie?
Uncivilized pictures that the newsreel takes of me.
So, bongo, 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 he don't wanna leave the Congo. No, 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 no. Bongo, he's so happy in the jungle, he refused to go.
Don't want no penthouse, bathtub, streetcars, taxis, noise in my ear.
So no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here.
They hurry like savages to get aboard an iron train.
The Tringalingo Hula Humble Express.
And though it's smoky and it's crowded, they're too civilized to complain.
When they've got 2 weeks vacation,
they hurry to vacation ground.
What do, Donnie?
They swim and they fish, but that's what I do all year round.
So, bongo, 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 I don't wanna leave the Congo. No, 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 no. Bingo, bango, bongo, I'm so happy in the jungle, I refuse to go.
Don't want no jailhouse,
shotgun,
fish hooks,
golf club,
I got my spears.
So no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here.
They have things like the autumn bomb,
so I think I'll stay where I am.
Civilization, I'll stay right here.
That someone, somewhere, decided the phrase bingle, bangle, bungle was worth using as a lyric. I hope it makes you smile, too.
Thank you.
you'd stay by me, true to the very end. But you ran away the first rainy day, just a fair weather friend. I had a heart I gave you, but you had one to lend. For when skies were black, you took it right back, just a fair weather friend. Foolish me, I couldn't see the handwriting on the wall. Sunny skies had dimmed my eyes, I never thought that rain would fall. Just when I needed someone on whom I could depend, you walked out on me, what else can you be? Just a fair weather friend.
Friends, it's true that there are people in the world who will let you down, but it should just make you appreciate the folks who are always there for you even more. Radio. It's like a super stim pack for the soul. Oh, that sounded better in my head.
Mm-hmm.
love leaves you plenty of time to write songs about it. Here are the Ink Spots with Maybe. Description.
I love those dear hearts
and gentle people
who live in my hometown,
because those dear hearts and gentle people will never ever let you down. They read the good book from Friday till Monday. That's how the weekend goes.
That's how it goes.
I've got a dream house. I'll build there one day with picket fence and rambling rows. I feel so welcome each time that I return,
that my happy heart keeps laughing like a clown.
I love those dear hearts
and gentle people who live and love
in my hometown. They read the good book from Friday till Monday. That's how the weekend goes. I've got a dream
that my happy heart keeps laughing like a clown.
Like a clown.
I love those dear hearts
and gentle people
who live and love in my hometown.
In my hometown, those dear hearts and gentle people.
Set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. And that one is you, no other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. And that one desire is you. And I know nobody else ain't gonna do.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
Friends, keep things small, simple. Focus on the good things, the things that really matter. Oh, my goodness, I'm such a broken record. Okay, my brother Maddie, as a kid, oh boy, did he laugh at Fats Waller blurting out, "Believe me." Oh, Maddie, wherever you are, I hope you can hear this and I hope you're still laughing.
Thank you.
No one to walk with, but I'm happy on the shelf. A misbehaving, saving my love for you, for you, for you, for you. I know for certain the one I love. I'm through with flirting, it's you that I'm thinking of. A misbehaving, saving my love for you. Like Jack Horner in the corner, don't go nowhere, what do I care? Your kisses are worth waiting for. Leave me, I don't stay out late, no place to go. I'm home about eight, just me and my radio. A misbehaving, saving all my love for you.
Listeners, it's time once again to put aside all you think you know, all you believe to be true. Time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. In tonight's thrilling story, Sideshow Snallygaster. The carnival has come to the Tyler County Fairgrounds. Billy Harding and his dad wander past the games and rides, cotton candy in hand, peanut shells and popcorn crunching beneath their feet, as a sideshow barker touts a frightful attraction.
Hurry, hurry, hurry! Come one, come all! Come and see the Snallygaster! The most dreaded creature this side of creation! Once a winged beast hunting the prehistoric skies, the cruel mistress of time has turned its wings into mere appendages, spawning this fearsome six-legged monstrosity. Hurry, hurry, hurry! Step right up and behold the stupendous Snallygaster!
Dad, I want to go see the Snallygaster.
No, hogwash. Sideshows are a swindle, Billy. All just smoke and mirrors.
But he said it has six legs.
Trust me, son. When you get inside, all you'll see is a shaved bear with extra legs glued on.
Aw, Dad, please, I'm begging you.
Billy, Billy!
Whoa, whoa, slow down there, champ.
Sorry, Mr. Harding.
Hi, Teddy. Were you just in there looking at the Snallygaster? My dad says it's a fake.
I tried, but it costs five tickets.
Five tickets? It's gotta be real if it costs that much.
Yeah, that's what I thought, too.
You know, it was a carny who coined the phrase, there's a sucker born every minute.
Dad.
Anyway, when I didn't have enough tickets, I tried sneaking in.
You did not.
Did so. Sorry, Mr. H.
It's okay, Teddy. Your secret's safe with me.
Gee, thanks. So, I went around the back, looking for a place to sneak under the tent, and overheard two workers say the Snallygaster escaped.
Escaped? You're kidding.
All right. I hate to break it to you, boys, but that's just a publicity stunt to stir up intrigue.
Those men were scared stiff.
What should we do, Dad?
Well, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going home. If you two want to stay longer, then so be it.
But what about the Snallygaster?
Like I said, no such thing. Just don't dawdle too long, understand? They're closing soon.
Okay, Dad. You think he's right about it being fake?
I don't know.
Well, the only thing I have enough for is the funhouse. Wanna go?
Same here. Come on, it's this way. Wow, this funhouse is bonkers. It's the Hall of Mirrors. Get a load of me. My body looks so big and fat in the reflection.
And this mirror makes me look tall and thin.
Whoa. And this one makes you look like you have a tail.
Teddy, that's not your tail. It's the Snallygasters. Look out, it's coming right at you.
Ah! Its head stuck in the mirror.
Ew.
Look at all those eyes on its back.
The Snallygaster is real.
I knew it.
And look over there. Is that a body on the floor?
The Snallygaster must have killed him. Who knows how many other people it's gobbled up in here.
It's breaking loose. Let's scram.
Ah! It's got me. It's slim wrapped around me. Help me, Daddy.
Down, girl. Down.
It's the Carnival Barker. Help us.
Down!
I'm free!
That's right, girl. Easy now.
That was a close one.
Thank you so much, mister.
Say, where are your parents, boys?
We're here alone. But don't worry, we'll tell everyone all about this and how you saved our lives.
I was afraid you might say that.
What do you mean?
What I mean is that there's good publicity and there's bad publicity. And I always need to make sure I'm in control of both. A close call like this could be the end of business. And I can't risk that now, can I?
But, mister, we won't tell anyone if you don't want. We swear it, don't we, Teddy?
Cross our hearts and hope to die?
Well, now, I couldn't have said it better myself. Supper time, girl.
The next day, the carnival pulled up stakes and moved on to the next town because the show must go on at any cost. Be sure to tune in next week for another thrilling chapter of Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
Nice. place to live.